Good morning, evening, afternoon, boys, girls, in betweens, none of the above, is Admiral Price here, bringing you another co-op campaign with the Legend of Total War.
Good morning, afternoon, or whatever, I don't give a shit.
Or evening, if you're a boy, or girl, or an in-between.
Most likely you're a boy.
that's sexist.
No, it's a fact.
It probably is, actually. Although, there's a surprising a number of Twitch streamers that are women.
No, I meant viewers. I was referring to viewers. Most likely, if you're viewing, you're most likely a boy.
Yeah, have you looked at your demographics for gender? And I can just end the turn here.
Yeah, it's 3% female.
I wonder. I think you probably have the least amount of female viewers in all of the Total Warriors community.
Huh. That and makes he's like, me sad.
He's like, yeah, this should be in the kitchen.
I'm not like that. They should be all in the bedroom.
Time. Oh,
I can cook my own damn food.
Oh no, somebody died. Who died? Somebody killed somebody. I'm gonna kill you for killing somebody.
Research complete. Signaling. I can't remember. That was a week ago. Faction destroyed Pergamon. Okay, that's good. Alright, so what am I gonna research now? I was obviously doing something. I was planning towards something, but since that was a week ago, I've forgotten what exactly I wanted to do. Where is signaling? Oh, there it is. Okay, so I was going for that upkeep costs, right. Oh, that's pretty good. That gave me an extra 800.
Oh, yeah, that's a lot.
Yeah, minus 3% upkeep on these dirt cheap armies, so let's see. So, they went from, now they're costing the Eastern Spearmen with a level 9 or whatever dignitary, Magus, and now cost me 25 talents per turn.
It's beautiful. It's beautiful.
Yeah, it's pretty good. Alright.
Bro, that moment on your Vinny Vidi Vici campaign where you did exploit corruption and you got that one talent...
Yeah, I realize now that you've got to do that on a faction that's actually large. But the problem is, in Total War Attila, nobody ever gets large. Like, they all just crumble.
It's interesting. In my this is Total War campaign as the Roman expedition. The Ostrogoths actually are freaking huge. They have like 50 settlements.
Oh, okay. Yeah, in that particular campaign, but in the grand campaign, that particular technique can only be useful against Assassinids. That's it.
And even them, no, because most of their power comes from satrapies.
Yeah, it's this, I don't know, good idea, stupidly implemented. That's Attila in a nutshell.
I almost feel like, and as a person who loves this game, so don't anybody be like, oh my god, you're always complaining about the game. Stop complaining about the game. I feel like that's Total War in general.
No. Attila's the exception.
I don't know. I mean, it took Rome 2 17 or 18 patches to actually become a good game.
It's not going to happen with Attila. The thing is, Rome was like a buggy mess. Attila has like no bugs. There's not many bugs in it. It's just shit. Shit. That's all there is to it.
There's a lot of aspects of Attila that I enjoy, but I feel like there are two or three main problems with Attila that really make it not really worth it.
Yeah.
I'd
say it's more like 20 problems, but whatever.
I think the sacking and raising mechanic was a giant catastrophe. Because nobody ever grows. And the entire area just becomes a giant wasteland.
Well, yeah, one of my biggest problems with the game is that no one ever grows.
If they had made it in such a way that recolonizing areas was not that expensive, and that you didn't have like if you had a giant growth bonus for recolonized lands, I think it would have been actually a really decent mechanic raising, but raising. Plus the fact that recolonizing is so prohibitively expensive, the AI never does it. And the growth is just really, really stinted. So that you could recolonize a land, and then 25 years later, you can actually build that fourth building or something.
Yeah.
It becomes really tedious.
Yeah,
to recolonize lands.
That's Attila in a nutshell.
And I remember when we basically had this debate in, I think, 3 or 4 different strategy games. At this point, we had it when Civ 5's deity was just tedium. When EU4, when Johan took over as the main designer, and then he kind of implemented all these policies that basically made the game tedious, not difficult. And now we're having it here again. It's like, okay, you want difficulty, but you don't want tedium.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
Anyway,
I just declared war on the Seleucids, you know, just the average day around here. What are they going to do against my peasant stacks?
Wait, the Seleucids don't have Seleucia. What?
Well, they traditionally kind of fall apart in this game anyway.
Oh, okay. Good. Wow, and Armenia is really branching out here. Holy crap, man. Holy crap. What is going on with you, Armenia? You have so much land.
Do they? Who cares?
Yeah, Armenia.
I reckon the bigger they are, the easier they are to take down.
Okay. Is that how it works?
Yep, I think so.
Because I remember my war against Assassins and Attila, where I showed up with like 5 stacks, and they showed up with 16.
No, in this game.
In this game, okay. Ooh, I can get more dignitaries and spies. What? Why have I not been doing that? Why have I not been doing that? I'm an idiot. Don't say anything. I also do like that cultural differences actually matters in this game.
Yeah. What? Yeah. Okay. Yeah, so I'm just, like, doing these actions and trying to kill people. So you said you don't want to go to war with Armenia.
Not yet. I want to get rid of Sumeria first. I have this really strange thing where I only like one front wars. I'm a really cautious player, which sometimes makes some of my LPs a little bit...
I'm kind of cautious too, but when I know what I'm doing, I throw caution to the wind.
Yeah. In this game, I'm also kind of relearning the game because it's so different from when it was released. And I only played that
one campaign. You got me to teach you.
Yeah, that actually makes things a lot easier. If we do another MP campaign, we should definitely do a head-to-head.
Yeah. Probably not until after I get back from my honeymoon.
Oh, when's your honeymoon?
October.
Nice.
I would say
congratulations.
Going to Vanuatu. I just had my typhoid shot. It's kind of like getting a massive punch in the arm. It's East Island. It's like, I don't know. Middle of the Pacific Ocean. Somewhere.
Oh, okay. So either Polynesia or Hawaii?
Yeah, it's like that, but it's Vanuatu.
Okay. I don't understand why people would ever want to go anywhere ever for a honeymoon. Why not just stay home and sleep?
Yeah. Yeah, that would be nice, but... I don't know.
I mean, I don't understand it. Just stay home and sleep, brah. Sleeping is so awesome.
Yeah, I know.
Why would anybody not want to sleep?
Had my first vaccination in, like, years. The actual needle itself, I didn't even feel it, but the infection it causes is
yeah
kind of sore.
Yeah, I remember when I went for pilgrimage mecca and you have to get like 90 different vaccinations. Oh. Ugh. That and you have to poop in a can.
Oh, okay.
Because they won't let you enter the country until they know that you're free of diseases that are in that can only be detected in stool. So they make you poop in a can and then scoop your poop into a little cylinder and then give that to the doctor. Yeah. That was a fun experience.
Jeez. Okay. Anyway, your turn. Oh, Jesus.
All right, research complete. Multilingual. Assassinated. No! Let's see. Other nobles, royal family. I can lose 14 nobles for this guy. Sure, why not? And I will make you royal horse archers because those guys are awesome. Kind of. Let's see. Is there a speed setting here? No. Okay, yeah, because reasons.
I think I just lost Susa.
Oh, no. Saloha, the invaders are close. Perilously so. People run from the cities. Negative 360 nobles. What? They're not even close. The hell are you talking about? They're not even in the freaking settlement. Oh, my God. And now my influence is 24% because of that.
That's crap.
Because of that one thing with these stupid, oh, rebels at the gates, and there's nobody there! Okay, you're in the royal family, right?
What?
What's your name? Your name is Res Cupidus. Yes, you are a royal family. All right, let's get you some influence so that we can get some freaking nobles. Wait, how do you get nobles?
What? What nobles?
Influence is nobles, right?
What do you mean?
Influence is nobles, right? So your combined influence is the amount of nobles you have, right?
No, that's in what's it called? That's Attila. So influence is gained on a per turn basis. You have to grow your influence. So
right,
you need to secure promotions. Gravitas helps increase your influence whilst they're a statesman. So if they're a general, it's not really doing anything, but the thing is, being a general will increase their gravitas. So you basically give them a life in the military, get up their gravitas, get their ranks, and then in their last few years, make them a statesman, and they develop your influence.
I see. Okay. So that's actually a lot more interesting.
Yeah.
Okay, so here we'll build a what? A Wedu? I kind of want a Wedu because of the growth. I like growth.
Don't use Japanese English words.
I'm not using Japanese English words.
Yeah,
Wedu. Saying Wedu.
That's a Japanese word.
That's not a Japanese word.
Are you building a well?
I'm building a Wedu.
Is it a well?
Have you seen Saturday Night Live's J-Pop America Fun Time Now?
No. Don't watch that much TV.
It makes fun of those people who pretend they're Japanese even though they're not.
Oh, okay.
And it's so great. I am Jonathan Sanudu.
Okay.
So let's see. You can attack Trapezius without any issue whatsoever. Where's my spy? Where's my spy? No, my spy died. Where's my spy? Forces. Once you're a spy... Ah, there you are. Never mind. I sent you up north because of reasons. Oh, wait. I should not have sent you there. Okay.
There's a lot of wonders in the east.
Like yes,
there are. Every second settlement has a wonder. They're really good.
Well, let's hold off on this for a bit. Female suffrage. You probably need to recruit.
What?
I've called my army female suffrage.
All right. Why?
Because they're full of Amazonian warriors, so I'm naming them like after, you know.
Oh,
stuff.
Right, whatever.
Rough Riders are holding things down here. Good. How much instability do we have here? The instability is actually all gone. So slaves is -2, factions -4. Yeah.
What was the difficulty rating of your campaign?
Of which one?
Of yours, being Royal Scythia. Was it rated hard?
No, I was pretty sure it was very hard.
Oh, okay. Mine was just rated hard.
Oh, yeah?
It's not hard.
No, when you break the game, it's usually not hard.
Break the game? I'm playing exactly as the AI does. Auto-resolve.
You totally broke the game, bruh.
Did not.
Like, I can't even... What? Okay, we're gonna have to fight this out manually.
Again.
It's saying I don't have any chance to win.
Gotta bring more armies.
Or we could just manually resolve the freaking thing. Oh crap, I should have quick saved it.
Oh no.
Yeah, we have a tendency of crashing during the first battle of any given campaign.
I'm not sure why. Das ist Viad. The fires of... Where are they coming from? I want to know this question. I want to know the answer to this question because we'll just intercept them. And then kill the hell out of them. Let's see. It doesn't say. But wherever they come from is where we actually want to deploy. No, they're not out in the water. They're out in the land.
They'd have to be coming from... What are you on? They'd have to be coming from somewhere around here, I think, because you had visibility over this area here.
Yeah, I think you are right. You are right.
Alright. So, I reckon if you deploy in this general area here, you should be alright.
Okay, I'll deploy like this, and then I'll keep an eye out on the things. If you can deploy like here, and then keep an eye out towards the back. Just in case. I remember I just had a co-op with Danish Warrior Scald, and we were like, oh, you know, this is basically the deployment, right? We're like, oh, their positioning on the map was from here, so that they're definitely going to come from there, so let's put a block of Nordic band to block them.
No, you
right?
can't do that. You can't do that. It won't work. You have to give it some distance.
And like, we started...
There, right? There.
We deployed our skirmishers here. They deployed there, right there.
Oh, really? Wow.
We lost the entire navy.
You got to give it distance. If they're gonna deploy here, you need to deploy here.
All right, I'm trying to look for them. I can't see them so far. Enemy reinforcements approaching. I see them. Where? Oh, they're from the exact opposite end. Oh, yay.
They probably were somewhere else, but it doesn't matter. We got this. Right,
let's just double speed a little bit, or triple speed or whatever.
I'm right there. Oh, they got a lot of cavalry.
Yeah, they do. So we're going to have to be on skirmish mode a little bit.
Fuck skirmish mode. I hate skirmish mode.
And they have step lancers, too, which is actually fairly decently speeded cavalry. Although, they're going to get shredded because of no armor.
Oh yeah, they're getting shredded.
Let's try to take out their noble horse archers. Yeah, they have like no armor.
Oh, one of your guys, I guess. Got badly damaged. But he'll be okay, we've dealt out more damage than we've received.
Oh, pull back, run! Run, you idiot, run.
Our general is under attack.
Run!
This is probably what people want to hear, but Rome 2 is so much better than Attila.
Yeah, right now I'm far more concerned about saving my cavalry. Get this way. What is that, javelinman? Whew, okay, alright, that was a little bit hairy. I gave you an attack order, you idiot.
Step
And don't shoot at will. Don't shoot at will. Get in there. Oh my god, no, you're gonna get caught! You're gonna get caught! Stop running towards the building, no!
God, you should be on Sesame Street.
One dead horse archer. Two dead horse
archer. You do a good job of it.
Three dead horse archer.
Get in there.
Alright, so... Oh, no. We're killing those horse archers pretty well. It's all about numbers, I guess. We outnumber them.
Yeah. You're surrounded by horses. Why are you steady?
Some people don't care if they live or die.
Yeah. The general is dead. Okay. Well, that works.
That was all me. I came to your guys' rescue.
Their horses all went... I'm like, oh my god, look at those women! Run! That's basically what happened. Alright, good. Now that those guys are broken...
Should we give them a bit of a rest? Oh wait, there's no more cavalry. Have we killed off all the cavalry?
I think the vast majority of it. I think the cavalry that was inside the city still has some. Yeah, there's some citizen cavalry that was inside the city. They are they're still left.
I see it.
They also have two slingers. Let's see, any more slingers? Yeah, they have some four fatigue. Slingers. They have two slingers and three slingers and a javelin man. Other than that, yeah. So I'm just running my guys back and having them sit for a bit. No, stop shooting. Idiots.
Yeah. Also, let's shoot up the running away. Easily kill the citizen cav. These guys should be much faster.
Yeah. Alright, now I think we can go double speed a little bit.
It's up to you, you're in control of that stuff. I have no choice.
Oh yeah? You don't get a choice on it? Oh, run away! Run away! Stop shooting at me! I'm so out of my element here. Off my game.
Can you get back to normal speed?
Sure.
It would help. Help me make less mistakes.
Mistakes. I don't fear mistakes.
Well, it's your army. It's up to you. I don't care. If you want to put on triple speed and we lose, it's your fault.
It's never my fault. It's always your fault.
Please, I'm the horse archer master.
Your face is a master. I'm hilarious. Who the hell are you and why are you so damaged? Come on, get over here.
I hate it when there's just that one guy left that you're shooting at, and everyone shoots at him. It's just like, oh, it's overkill.
Oh, right. You guys not a fire at will. Oops. I'm not an idiot.
Alright, now for their infantry, which I reckon will be a little bit more difficult.
No, don't get caught! Don't get caught! Alright, yeah. Oh my god, General! Oh my god, my general is slower than the citizen cavalry. Good job, general. Good job.
He's heavy.
Yeah, you idiot. Heavy horse archers. Like, what?
I need you to come and kill these slingers.
Yeah, I'm pulling around.
Because I can't get close to them because these guys have javelins.
Yeah. Why are they still standing around, the four guys left in the unit? You have four guys left in the unit. Run already, you idiot. All right. Now, we want to aim for the slingers, right?
Yeah, get rid of the slingers.
So I'm going to go off fire at will then. And then shoot at the slingers. Oh, wrong button. R- Run. I keep trying to toggle loose form, and then I remember, oh yeah, no loose form.
This isn't the battle that calls for loose formation anyway, I think.
Against the slingers, yeah, I would
no,
say...
No, 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 if you've got superior numbers, don't go loose formation. Reduces your firepower. Loose formation isn't always the go-to as soon as you get into a skirmish. If you've got superiority, don't use loose formation.
Yeah, I mean, it depends on situation, sure.
Yeah.
But, in general, when you're trying to minimize losses...
Yes, yes, yes. The way to minimize losses is to kill your enemy quickly. Okay, not have them miss 20% more. If you can kill them 50% faster, javelins? You need to stay in formation.
Come
the
on.
Thing is, when you get into loose formation, spaces man, there's some units that get out of range.
Yeah. No, the reason why I was using loose form, or why I use loose form with mobile skirmish units, is because a lot of times they don't get away out of range immediately. And if they're spaced out a little bit, it's, why are you guys running so idiotically? It's sometimes easier. Whatever, I'm not speaking right now. I'm trying to micro.
Yeah, that's alright.
Like, sometimes it's sometimes...
It's alright, I know what that's like.
I almost feel like not putting them on fire at will. So that... they're not shooting at their shields and heavy armor, so you guys can shoot them.
Getting a little bit low on ammunition. These guys on the wings there aren't exactly shooting very often.
Wait, who's used ammunition?
One of my guys.
Oh, okay.
Just gotta get him off the field.
I got tons of ammo left, but that's the main reason why I don't want to go fire at will right now.
Gunfire at will. I'm just gonna kill whatever.
It's because I want to get efficient kills, if not necessarily tons of kills all at the same time.
One of our units has used all its ammunition.
I wish you could tell them shoot while moving and then give them a move order. And then give them an attack order on somebody.
Yeah, that would be great. I think that just requires a bit more micromanagement. You just gotta be quick with the clicks.
Yeah. Alright, you guys get there. Alright.
One of our units has used all its ammunition.
Okay, I got 4 units left with ammunition. 2 of them have quite a lot of ammo. I think we've taken out quite a number of battalions. Although, you know, reluctant to go into melee. They've got a lot of hoplites here.
Yeah. I'm just using one guy as bait and then shooting the backs of them.
Yeah, I'm just shooting them straight in the face. I think we've got enough ammunition for that.
One of our units has used all its ammunition.
Alright, good. You guys are done. Off of fire at will, please. Yeah, this is actually working fairly well. Very efficiently taking guys out.
I also reckon the music's better in this than in Attila. Slightly. Still not great.
I actually really like the Mongolian throat singing.
I don't like that.
Yeah, my walking speed is basically the same as their running speed.
They must be pretty tired.
Yeah.
Alright, we're gonna have to go into melee, I think.
No, I have tons of ammo left.
Oh yeah, well, this, I'm almost out of ammo.
This
I asked you specifically to get rid of the slingers. The battle is turning in our favor. That doesn't matter, okay.
Yeah, the using bait thing is really working. No, stop shooting at Will, you idiot.
Just gotta get rid of these damn slingers that keep shooting us.
And I hate these female warriors' stupid rawr noises. It just sounds like a bunch of cats going.
Yep. One of our units has used all its ammunition.
Yeah, those slingers can definitely be run down. No problem there.
Yeah, the slingers are giving me the shits. Oh, that went well.
Alright, yeah, those hoplites are done. Which means we can go.
I think the battle's done.
Oh, yeah?
Yep, everything's wavering.
Alright, let's just go ahead and smash everybody then.
There's no need. Sure, just give it 1 second and.
No, as in, make sure we run them off the field.
Why?
Not run them off the field. Eliminate them all. Because this one's not an army. I mean, this one's not a station inside the city. This was outside the city. It's a little retreat.
Oh, right, yeah. Of course. Speed it up. I'm surprised these guys are still hanging around. They must have some experience. You may want to turn off fire at will if you're coming over here.
Yeah, I'm off of fire at will. Almost all my guys are off. I think all my guys are off of fire at will. Yeah. I had them off of fire at will because I was just, I was using a few of them for bait and then telling which ones to attack.
Yeah, speed it up.
So. Alright, come on, buddy.
Oh, no.
Kill those Scythian hoplites, you idiot. Why are you guys not killing the Scythian hoplites? Get over here.
Yeah, they don't do... These horse archers don't do a very good job of running people down. Oh my goodness, they're really dumb.
Yeah. Really dumb is a little bit of an understatement here. One of our units has used all its ammunition. Is that everybody?
Yep. Good all enough. Right.
And they said we had no chance to win. It's pretty funny. Oh no, they still have 251 remaining. Aww.
Do they? Where from?
Not sure. Maybe the reinforcing army? I don't know, 50 hoplites got away because guys were idiots.
We're pretty heavily outnumbered as well.
Yeah.
No, but it's quality over quantity. You'd imagine a resolve battle, but that's why you gotta bring quantity over quality in auto-resolve.
Auto-resolve, yeah. Yay! Alright, we can just occupy or we can liberate. Nah, screw that.
The thing is, your army, that one army there, could probably take out 3 of my stacks. In manually resolve.
Sorry, should we occupy? Should we sack? Should we raid? I think we just occupy it. I don't like the instability.
Because the only thing I could possibly do was 2 things I could do. Either wait for you to run out of ammunition. Of course, you guys have tons of ammo.
Yeah.
Or try and, like, set up a steamroll. Like, a line from one side of the map to the other and just push you to the edge of the map and kill you that way. But you'd kill me before I can get it done because they're Eastern Spears. They don't even have much armor.
Probably. I think I can get a harbor.
But then again, if I lost an army of these, it doesn't matter at all.
Yeah. Probably doesn't matter at all. Let's see, what do you guys have? 2 more turns and you can recruit Amazonians. Well, let's see. How much does it cost to actually get these agents out? Oh, bro, it costs. It costs. Agents are expensive.
Oh, I think you said Asians, right.
You would. What's better for a general? Authority, zeal, or cunning?
That's up to you. It depends on what kind of general do you want him to be.
I usually do sit back and inspire all the units general.
Alright, historically, I would say the cunning generals are the best. Because you need... I mean, all the best generals in history had cunning. They also had authority, and they also had zeal, so...
All the best generals in history had all the stats.
Yeah.
Basically.
Yeah, you gotta have all three. Historically, but in this, I'd go cunning. I always go cunning. Because cunning is, like, smart. Authority is, like... I don't know. Joffrey.
Authoritative.
It's not really, like, I don't know, whatever.
I want to recruit a priest here. Let's see. What do you have?
Cunning. Plus one general's order. Understanding of strategy and tactics.
Ooh, plus three tax rate. Nice. Plus one authority, occupying general. No, we'll get this guy because he has plus 4% tax collection from the tribute collection edict, plus one cultural conversion, plus three tax rate. Yes, please. You are mine for the taking. Okay, and for the last bucks we have, get a couple of these guys. And let's quickly... Oh, crap, I forgot to get the... I forgot to get the ship. Well, I'll do it next turn, maybe. Well, I can't really take any money out of anything to get the ships. I'll pop that down one level. Okay. I think that's about it. All right, so Mordos, my faction leader, has 234 influence. I mean, he has 234 gravitas. He's wounded. Next turn, he'll come out as a statesman. So if I leave him in the capital, he will grow the nobles, right?
The influence.
This senseless war can end today. And the influence is the number of nobles that you have on your side. As you wish.
Seleucids won a peace treaty.
Didn't you just declare war on them?
Yeah. I'm going to see if I can squeeze just a little bit of cash out of them.
And then declare war on them again.
Not right away. They're not exactly on my border. Let us go and give thanks. That's why I was considering Dionysus, it.
Because
I just had sort of like an odd region, Charax. I just thought, yeah, I'll take that. Sit by way. The region next closest to me is like... I don't know, one over here. Yeah, I figured I'd be losing this. I thought the garrison was larger. Doesn't matter. I'll take it back.
Which city?
Susa.
Ah, Susa. We used to have a cat in our neighborhood called Susa.
Martial priorities. As your enemies gain strength, it's blah, blah, blah. Okay, infantry recruitment gives. Recruitment costs. Whatever. Yeah, focus on infantry, because that's what I'm getting anyway. Faction joins my enemies. Whatever. The Getae, or whatever. I can't get to the city in this turn. It's just out of range. Oh, that's a pain. Should be able to get it next turn, though. I don't see any reason why not.
Holy crap. Even with my army totally present, they're losing 14 a turn. Yaw. 15 from cultural differences. That's insane.
Okay, sabotage that Persian army so it doesn't move. Or at least it doesn't move far. It'll probably try and run away. Will they critically? No, they won't critically. That's okay. And then sabotage this Median army. Good, successful. Very, very nice. So, these guys are sabotaged how badly? Oh, God damn it. Critical, good. So they ain't moving. Because we can't quite reach them. This region here, I probably shouldn't have taxed it in the first place, because... Yeah, whatever. Okay, why is the public order here so bad? Raiding. Right, that's why. So we got to put a stop to this butt wanker over here. Can't do that this turn, though. Just out of range. But that's alright. Now, you said you didn't want to go to war with Armenia, didn't you?
Yeah, not yet.
Yeah.
Although my armies are actually in position.
Let us conclude our business with good haste.
You said you didn't want to go to Armenia. War with Armenia.
Yeah, I'm like that.
Yeah. No, my armies are in position, so I should be able to deal with it.
You won't have to at this rate. Looks like you've got some Carthly rebels to deal with.
Yeah. I think I'm just going to attack them this turn. I was letting them stick around just to raise my public order here.
Yeah.
And then I was just going to kill them once the malcontents bonus ran out. I'm doing the same in Fangoria. Fangoria, whatever the hell it's called.
Yep. It's not that I don't like Armenians, it's just they're on my border, which means they need to die.
Yeah. Oh crap, you took the... Oh, okay, no, that's fine.
What?
They're not the cities in the settlement, that's mine. Sinope, and so basically this area is has my cities. Mm-hmm. It has the same cities as my
so if I took them, that would Sinope, be very annoying for
Amnesia,
you.
And Nicomedia, yeah. If you took them, they'd be very annoying for me. Yes, that would be very annoying. Hey, we have a direct border now. Well, I mean, we had like a small one there, but now we have like a much bigger one.
Yeah. Okay. Cool. Get rid of this. Get rid of that.
I need more dignitaries.
Yeah. Oh, wait. I just gained Imperium, and I can now get 3 of each agent. That's good.
Yeah.
Because I can get cheaper armies.
Oh god.
How can I serve you? Good, good, good. Alright, let's see. Oh, that's right, Persia took that. I don't see anything else that needs to be done. So, I've got 8 armies currently. 8 full-stack armies with an income of 10,000. Should I train another spy?
I think spies and dignitaries are like the most useful ones, right?
I definitely need another champion here, because public order's not great.
Champions raise public order, what?
Veterans or whatever they are. Yeah, you put them to their thing, their military fervor, it raises public order.
Wow.
Not by heaps, but you know, when they level up, it can be like plus 10 or more.
Oh. That's insane. So here we'll give the grove, the consecrated ground, and the Wedu. If he's recruiting in the settlement and I besiege it, does that stop his recruitment?
What?
If he's recruiting in the settlement and I besiege it, does that stop the recruitment?
I don't know. It has in the past, but you know, I just lose track of these things sometimes. These updates. Time to raise another peasant stack. Okay, and another one. Why not? Why don't we get two new armies? Why not? Our enemies are abundant and weak.
Are we ever going to see your cataphracts?
Not at this rate.
Because I would love to, like, run around with some Eastern cataphracts just wrecking things.
Just not efficient.
Yeah, but it's fun.
But I like efficiency. Efficiency is fun for me.
You're like a Roomba.
What?
There's a EU4 player, one of the biggest EU4 channels, a Roomba. And everything is just like, oh, let's... He spent 2 hours on Twitch once on a spreadsheet.
Yeah, and I'm not like that.
And there were 2,000 people watching. It was actually quite interesting. But still, there was 2,000 people watching.
Jesus.
This was when Common Sense, the expansion, just came out, and the attrition for the AI was bugged. And so he was trying to figure out what was wrong with it. And so he was plugging in different numbers on the spreadsheet.
Jeez.
For 2 hours. It's like, if you move here, we get this much attrition. They got that much attrition. At the end of it, he's like, oh, the attrition for enemies is halved.
Yeah, okay. I can't really play EU4. I get so bored.
I love EU4. It's a really, really fun game. And now, if they had manually resolved battles, it would be, like, even greater.
It's also in a time period I don't particularly care for. I don't really care for, like, gunpowder era. So I like Crusader Kings 2 more. It's more my type of era. Just Middle Ages.
Yeah. Okay, so Broski is now a statesman raising raising our political thingamajigger. Monsieur, you need a whole bunch of money to become next rank. Can we marry you? I would like to marry you. All right, let's marry you. And okay, what did that do for my politics?
I have 27 regions owned now. That's pretty good.
That's decent.
10 out of 10.
Here, we'll build a wedu and a consecrated ground.
Consecrated.
Ayand or here, Monsieur Schuismic. You can go ahead and deploy. Increasing tax rate. And the cultural something something and the blah blah blah. Okay, go ahead. And okay. You can also get down here and increase the rate at which these guys start becoming nomadic. Let's see, come on. Yeah, it's going up by 4.2% a turn. And I think we can go ahead and attack the Cartlean rebels now.
I'd say that if we're going to make another episode today, we probably need to break it up about now.
Okay, all right, so let's end here. So, like and subscribe, guys. Don't forget to check out Monsieur Legend of Total War's channel. And if Monsieur of Legend of War, if you will.
No.
What?
No.
Yes.
Nope.
Do it.
All right. I'll see you next time, fuckers.